So here you have the solar installation of Migrovo, which is 1 megawatt in capacity, roughly 4,000 solar panels. It was built a few years back, and this project was the result of a partnership between Migrovo and Romande Energie. So the idea today is to do a drone test and thermal mapping of the solar installation. Basically, it will help us see which panels produce at 100% and which ones are a bit less optimal, as some we have noticed are dirty due to the pollution of the air. Because of the certain works we did on the installation, we realized that also 19 solar panels aren't producing currently. We hope that the drone test will enable us to find out which ones it is. Well, normally we would have one guy go up the roof physically and take pictures one at a time with a thermal camera, which on 4,000 panel installation could take some time. And then having to compare one another, it's a much more complicated job than having an aerial view, obviously, of the installation, which is done thanks to the drone in 5 minutes. So big gain of time and of energy. So what did we learn after the first flight of the eBee at Migros-Blanc? Is that the solar installation was generally dirty. The modules were literally filthy. The good news was that the 19 panels seemed to be producing, meaning that we had to go through a painstaking exercise of checking that this was the case, meaning counting the panels and going through all the technical data. There was also 19 hotspots that were identified due to different reasons, shading, dysfunctional panels, or broken panels, meaning that each one of these also had to be analyzed. So we did a tour with the eBee a few months later and a nice hot summer day. It was after having cleaned practically all the panels. We left a few on purpose to check the difference between a clean panel and a dirty one. There's a clear difference between clean and dirty panels. In average, we could see in the thermal images approximately 7 degrees, which is a significant amount. We also managed to identify the probable causes of the hotspots. Certain are clearly due to shading, which we can't do much about, but others are most certainly due to malfunction or broken panels, which will enable us to guide our maintenance team in order to intervene and replace panels if necessary. So what are the benefits of using drones? Well, an asset manager has a certain number of tools at his disposal to check the performance of the solar installations. He has monitoring systems, he has a whole bunch of equipment on site that collects data, and of course visual inspections, but that isn't always enough. What's really nice about the drones is that it gives a new set pair of eyes. I mean, it's thermal imaging, meaning that problems appear much more easily and in a larger scale, which kind of puts everything in retrospect compared to normal analysis or data crunching or other methods used. It's also an enormous gain of time. If we need teams to go through the panels one by one, checking if everything is all right or taking pictures, it would take days. Whereas here, a site of 4,000 panels took approximately 5 minutes. So the benefits are clearly there.